Dear viewers, I am Muhammad Abdul Sami Siddiqui from Department of English, Maulana Azad National Urdu University, Hyderabad. I welcome you all to this class of MA English first year. Today, we shall talk about the evolution of novel. Novel is a form of writing. We shall discuss about its growth and development through different periods of literature. We shall begin with the 18th century novelists, then we shall proceed to the 19th century and finally the 20th century. We see the beginning of English literature in the Old English or Anglo-Saxon period, whereas novel as a form of literature comes in the late 17th century. This means that novel is a comparatively new form of literature. Even the word novel means new. It is a fictional story in prose. Literary historians find a parallel between the rise of novel and the rise of middle class in England. With the introduction of printing industry, there was an increase in the number of educated individuals in England. The spirit of curiosity and scientific temper were being induced by the organizations like the Royal Society. In different forms of writing, the emphasis was on reality. This emphasis led to the development of various prose forms like diary writing, travelogues, journal writing and essay writing. Such prose works of the 16th and 17th centuries contributed to the genesis of novel as a literary form. Novel as a form provided the author a choice to develop characters and situations close to the real life, which was a demand of the times. Novel acquired its modern form by the mid 18th century. Daniel Defoe, Jonathan Swift and Samuel Richardson are some of the initial novelists. Their works like Robinson Crusoe, Gulliver's Travel and Pamela are considered as the pioneering work in literature. Henry Fielding and Lawrence Sterne further developed novel as an independent form of literature. Henry Fielding's novels have a picaresque quality with their episodic plots. Sterne's Tristram Shandy gives us the life and opinions of its hero instead of his life and adventures. The next novelist who deserves a special mention is Oliver Goldsmith. He is known for his analysis of character and also for the style. His most famous work is Vicar of Wakefield. It initiated the genre of domestic fiction, which was popular among the Victorian authors. Dr. Johnson used novel as a medium for propagating moral philosophy. His novel Rasselas can be mentioned in this regard. In the 19th century, Jane Austen is a major novelist. She discarded sensationalism of Gothic novels like Horace Walpole's The Castle of Otranto. Jane Austen paved way for detailed study of English country life in her novels like Pride and Prejudice, Emma, and Sense and Sensibility. Some 30 years after Jane Austen, the Bronte sisters used the novel of terror for depiction of human passion.
Charlotte Bronte's Jane Eyre, Emily Bronte's Wuthering Heights and Anne Bronte's The Tenet of Wilfeld Hall are the examples. Sir Walter Scott was the pioneer of historical novel. He used to tell his story with the picturesque detail and romantic feeling proper to the bygone age.
Ivanhoe and The Talisman are some of his famous novels. With Charles Dickens begins a new phase in the history of novel. He uses a complex plot and includes his own experiences of London slums in his novels. He is known for the supreme individual portraits. His novels are filled with humor, pathos, and a deep sympathy for human nature. He had a reformist purpose in his work. His oft-quoted novels are Oliver Twist, David Copperfield, and Great Expectations.
William Thackeray is a contemporary of Charles Dickens.
He is famous for the novels of ideas. Vanity Fair is a masterpiece by him. He has also written a historical novel, Henry Esmond. George Eliot included philosophical issues in her novels. She has religion, politics, and the social conventions of her times as the subject matter of her novels. Adam Bede, The Mill on the Floss, Silas Marner, and Middlemarch are her representative novels. Thomas Hardy and George Meredith are the important writers of late 19th century. George Meredith makes use of satire in his fiction. Man's spiritual growth is the subject of his work, like The Ordeal of Richard Feverel and The Egoist. Thomas Hardy has a completely different outlook of life. His method of presenting this outlook is also quite different from George Meredith. He does not propagate any philosophy.
The rustics of Wessex are the characters of his novels.
He presents their inner soul without affecting the narrative. The Return of the Native, The Mayor of Casterbridge, and Jude the Obscure are some of his remarkable novels. The tragic ambience of these novels is also equally remarkable.
Charles Kingsley, Benjamin Disraeli, and Elizabeth Gaskell also belong to the 19th century.
They are known for political and social novels.
Similarly, Sir Henry Rider Haggard and Robert Louis are known for the novel of adventure. Treasure Island is an important work by Robert Louis.
During the same period, Wilkie Collins wrote detective fiction. The Woman in White and The Moonstone are the famous novels by him. The 20th century life and literature were greatly affected by two world wars. There was a break from traditions of Romantic and Victorian periods. Henry James and Joseph Conrad are the significant writers. Their works are the first indicators of this change. For them, the mind of their characters is of the greatest importance. The Heart of Darkness is a significant work by Joseph Conrad. The Portrait of a Lady is an important work by Henry James. The world of external reality is the concern of Arnold Bennett and H.G. Wells. H.G. Wells has also made a considerable contribution to science fiction. John Galsworthy's The Foresight Saga also tells the story of changes that have occurred from Victorian times to modern times. The spirit of experimentation was at its highest point, especially in the early decades of the century. The theories propounded by Sigmund Freud and others also had an influence on the modern minds and thereby on modern novel. The psychological theories gave birth to a different narrative technique known as stream of consciousness. With this technique, not just the point of view, but also the locale of the novel changed. Dorothy Richardson used this technique for the first time in her novel Pointed Roofs, which was published in the year 1915. James Joyce is the most authoritative and complex writer among the modernists. Dubliners, which is a collection of short stories by him, and Ulysses, a portrait of an artist as a young man, and Finnegan's Wake, these are the novels by him. These works are important for their technique as well as their subject matters.
Virginia Woolf further refined the technique in her novels like Mrs. Dalloway and To the Lighthouse.
D.H. Lawrence is another bold writer of the century. He dealt with the unusual subjects in his novels.
Sons and Lovers, The Rainbow, Women in Love, and Lady Chatterley's Lover are some of his major works.
These novels are remarkable not just for the psychological theories they are influenced by, but also for an insight into human relationships. The end of Second World War is the beginning of postmodernism in English literature. Graham Greene and Evelyn Waugh are the initial writers of this period. Their novels are clearly different from the modernist novels. The absence of order in society, the prevalence of evil, the anxieties of atomic age are presented by distanced characters with multiple point of views and satirical wit. L.P. Hartley, C.P. Snow, Anthony Powell are some of the writers who talk about the postmodern reality in their works. Similarly, Joyce Carey's contribution cannot be neglected. Kingsley Amis's Lucky Jim is an example of the disillusionment of the 50s. Lawrence Durrell and William Golding are known for the experimental tendency. Golding's novels, The Lord of the Flies, which was published in the year 1954, and Pincher Martin, which was published in the year 1956, explore the innate evil in man.
Muriel Spark, Eris Moldock, Margaret Drabble
are the feminist voices of the post-war period. Doris Lessing also deserves a special mention.
One finds economy and precision in the works of Muriel Spark.
She also makes use of supernatural elements in her novels. Memento Mori, The Ballad of Peckham Rae, and Public Image are some of her works. Eris Moldock presents the existentialist philosophy in her works like Under the Net and Flight from the Enchanter. Doris Lessing works on the earthly social realities. Children of Violence is a work by her. It is actually a sequence of 5 novels. The struggle of individual conscience against the collective is central to it.
In The Milestone and The Waterfall, Margaret Drabble explores the plight of modern women.
Among other novelists, Edna O'Brien, Elizabeth Bowen, A.S. Beat, Penelope Mortimer also share a feminist concern. Here, we have discussed the development and growth of novel from 18th century to present times. We have tried to touch all the crucial authors and trends. But we have not focused on the development of novel in American literature and other English speaking countries. The development of novel in Indian English is also not covered. Let me share with you some of the points which should be remembered from this discussion. The first point is, novel is comparatively a new form of literature, and literary historians, they find a parallel between the rise of novel and the rise of middle class in England. The second thing is,
Daniel Defoe's Robinson Crusoe, Jonathan Swift's Gulliver's Travel and Samuel Richardson's Pamela are some of the initial novels.
Daniel Defoe, Jonathan Swift, Samuel Richardson, Henry Fielding, Lawrence Stern, Oliver Goldsmith and Dr. Johnson are the major novelists of the 18th century.
Jane Austen, Sir Walter Scott, Charles Dickens, George Eliot, Thomas Hardy, George Meredith, Charles Kingsley, Benjamin Disraeli, Elizabeth Gaskell, Sir Henry Rider Haggard, and Robert Louis
are the novelists of the 19th century. Henry James, Joseph Conrad, Arnold Bennett, H.G. Wells, John Galsworthy, Dorothy Richardson, James Joyce, Virginia Woolf, and D.H. Lawrence belong to the first half of 20th century. They are known as modern novelists. Graham Greene, Evelyn Waugh, L.P. Hartley, C.P. Snow, Anthony Powell, Joyce Carey, Kingsley Amis, Lawrence Durrell, and William Golding belong to the second half of the 20th century. They are known as postmodern novelists. Feminist writing is one of the most interesting developments in fiction in the post-war years.
Muriel Spark, Eris Murdoch, Margaret Drabble, Doris Lessing, Edna O'Brien, Elizabeth Bowen and Penelope Mortimer
have also written about the issues of women in their novels. Dear students, I suggest you to read more about this topic from the books on History of English Literature. One of the books I am suggesting you is An Outline History of English Literature. It is written by W.H. Hudson. You can contact your counselors. You can also contact me on this address. Sami Siddiqui, Department of English, Maulana Azad National Urdu University, Hyderabad. You can email me at sami_siddiqui2001@yahoo.com. I hope you must have enjoyed the discussion. Let's meet some other time with some other topic of your interest. Goodbye.